I am Danica Montenegro and I am going to talk about the purpose of citing sources. It is important not only to get information from credible sources, but also to properly document our ideas, information, concepts, arguments for information and attributes than the authors or creators. This is done by citing sources. This procedure, which is an integral part of academic and professional writing, serves the following purposes. So first, to give credit to the original author of the works. This is to avoid plagiarism. Plagiarism is a serious offense in which someone takes and uses ideas, information, concepts, arguments, or information of someone else intentionally or unintentionally, without proper citation. Plagiarism can put you in jail, if ever. So second is to promote scholarly writing. Scholarly writing means that you are able to exhaustively use related and existing ideas, information, concepts or arguments of an expert, and to properly attribute this to the original source. Third, is to help your target audience identify the original source. More often than not, your target audience or readers want to either verify the information or learn more about the information from the original source. With your proper citations, your target audience can easily identify the location of the original source used in your paper. So that is the purpose for citing sources. Thank you.
Good day everyone, I am Tina and this is Mikaela and we will talk about forms of citation. So there are various styles or formats used to cite sources. But there are only two forms of citation, which is the in-text citation and the reference citation. So first let me talk about the in-text citation. So in-text citation requires the writer to cite the details of the reference used in a certain part of his or her essay. So the format of in-text citation varies per style. An example of that is the APA citation.
So reference citation is reference to the complete bibliographic entries of all references used by the writer. And a reference citation is documentation needed to make your paper acceptable to academic purpose, and it gives authority to the reader or gives source for your statement to access those sources and acknowledge the fact that the information used in the paper did not originate with the writer.
So that is four forms of citation. Thank you.
The first is the in-text parenthetical details in every paper. Depending on the type of source and the entry of the paper's citation page. The first detail in your references in text citation is to also the first thing that will appear in the listed works citation page. The second is this trial follows the author page method. Note that the author's name appear in a sentence, but page number should always be in the parenthetical citation and in the sentence.
Everyone, my name is Shaila Pizan and my topic is all about style guides. These citations are governed by rules of style and structure, which are generally published as style guides and manuals. First, the publication manual of the American Psychological Association, APA. Second, the Modern Language Association Style Guide, MLA. Third, Institute of Electrical and Electronic Engineers, IEEE. Fourth, American Medical Association Manual of Style, AMA. Five, the Chicago Manual of Style. Each style guide is prepared by specific discipline as shown below. APA is Psychology, Education, Hotel and Restaurant Management, Business business, economics, and other social sciences. MLA, Literature, Arts, and Humanities. IEEE, Engineering. AMA, Medicine, Health Science, and other natural sciences. Chichago, Reference Books, Non-Academic Periodicals, Newspapers, Magazines, Journals, among others.
Discussed by Smith et al.
one. The result demonstrates a correlation between speed and damage. This is the wrong time, and it because it has two or more authors. So that's all. As to indicate the specific topic or subject where the source came from.